Turn the motherfucking music up.
Just praise, man. Owe me, nigga.
Yeah. Home of Biggie Smalls, Rockefeller headquarters, ladies and gentlemen, Killer Cam, Young Hov is definitely in the building, Brooklyn, Harlem World, stand the fuck up, I'm a BK brawler, Marcy Project's hallway orderer, pure coke copper, get your order up, bring him to Baltimore in the Florida Explorer, it's gonna cost you more, but I gotta get him to Florida. Ruck a game agenda with the bench park on the sidewalk with the 10th place on the fender. I ain't hard to find, you catch me front and center. Nick game, big chain and all my splendor. Next to Spike and the pan left to right. My old man square, catch me at the fight. But damn, once again, if the pan left to the right, so be the man that right checks with the hand that don't write. I go off the head when I'm rambling on the mic, and I go off the fast when I'm scrambling at night. And it was off the setup or hammers to the fight, but we from New York City, right, Candy?
Damn right.
Hello.
Hello, everybody. Oh, yeah, put up chairs. We're back. It's another week. Can you believe it? Let the peoples pile in here. How's everybody doing this week? Another week.
But we made it. Here we are.
Shit happening. As you can tell, it's a New York theme. So we're paying tribute to the city that... Actually, we'll get to that later. Well, we've got some nicknames. We've got some quiz for Megan, some New York City trivia for Megan.
We have some nicknames. We have some things. We'll see what I don't know.
We also have a special guest in John Starks. As you can tell, we gave you a little glimpse of that. Some dunk action. It's actually just the dunk, if you know. I'm currently wearing a Brooklyn t-shirt, but only because I'm repping my guy. So don't get any ideas, Nets. No, I'm just playing. So yeah, we're excited. It's a New York City.
This is really fun. I mean, we got John Starks on at the conclusion of The Last Dance. He played such a big part in that. He was like antagonist number one. And
So much fun watching those Knick teams. Like, so much fun. I remember, what year was it?
Megan.
So strong.
I'm not good at making
them. No, it's good. It's delicious.
Yeah, it's good.
Anyways, I remember. Not like all of it.
Oh, I gotta pin the t-shirts.
During the time.
We had a big week at Hunger Not Impossible. I think last week we were 25,000 or so meals donated, maybe 26,000 last week. We're up over 35,000 meals donated. Again, we're gonna pin the link to the merch for a touch more.
Yeah, for the
sweatshirts,
gear.
T-shirts, all that kind of stuff. All the proceeds is going to Hunger Not Impossible. If this is your first time in here, Hunger Not Impossible. They basically donate meals to families and kids who have food insecurities or who can't get the meals themselves. So it's great. It's like right in the local community, partnering with Boys and Girls Clubs. Boom. Again, 35,000 meals donated. So thank you to you guys. Pin the thing.
Go ahead.
Just a quick note. As everything starts to open back up, just be safe. Be respectful. Be careful. Wear your masks. Wash your hands. Wear your gloves. Like, just be really safe and really careful. Like, kind of nothing changed about the virus. Everyone's just getting back out there. And we know the weather's getting nice and everyone's getting antsy as fuck. We are.
Yeah.
It's hard.
It is hard. It's definitely hard.
Let's just keep in this and stay strong. And we know we have to get out a little bit more, but like, just keep staying safe. Our death numbers, unfortunately, are just about to pass 100,000, and that's like fucking crazy. And so if you're going out, just be safe and be safe around everyone else around you. Okay. It's our PSA for the day. And thank you to all of the frontline workers and healthcare workers and everybody who's still out there keeping us safe and, you know, doing the things that we absolutely need them to. So, yeah.
Before we get into some of our regularly scheduled programs, we do have a YouTube channel now. We both do. So youtube.com/MeganRapinoe
Yeah.
/SueBird So you can check out all kinds of things, but definitely the show will get replayed on that.
Yeah. All the episodes are going up there live. And then we have like miscellaneous other stuff that we're doing throughout the week or career highlights or whatever is going on.
And then available on Wednesday on Spotify will be the podcast version of this.
They're going to turn all this shenanigans.
But you can get it on, you know, wherever you listen to your podcast. Yeah. You know the drill on that. And then the playlist, as always. I actually pre-posted it, so it's on my story right now. So you can go check out the playlist.
Yeah, Spotify playlist is fire. It's should we like start 900 million hours long.
Yeah, this one's long. So it was good. Actually, like, at some point I had to, like, stop myself. Because it was just, like, I couldn't.
It's New York City.
Like, even, like, the Jay-Z, Biggie, like, sections, I didn't go that hard because I was like, if I could literally, and this is actually an idea that you had, I could literally just do a Jay-Z night or a Biggie night. So we'll see. Should we check in real fast? Because the check-in is actually your call. It's actually themed
should
for tonight.
Just bring him up here?
That's a lot. My legs don't do that.
You don't think?
Okay.
You don't think
I'll stand up.
You stand up. Well, okay, so this is,
A lot. I'm going to do this.
Okay.
So we're gonna flip, and so it's a dunk theme.
I'm rocking the Come de Garcon dunk collab here. If I had pink socks underneath here, you'd be seeing some pink there, see-through. And honestly, I really love them.
And then, I mean, no words.
I love those too.
We don't need words for these guys, do we? Just
fire.
Getting it. Okay.
Straight fire.
Boom. And we're back.
Okay, and we're back. Get ourselves situated. Turn that light off.
Yeah, so that's the check-in. Dunk theme. Because you know who's coming soon. And you know why he's coming.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, since we'll stick with the high techie over here, we've got some knees cuteness for you. This is coming in
they keep
the
getting better pictures. And better.
Okay, so my niece Alex drew a family portrait. On the left is her dad, who wears a red sweatshirt all the time. In the middle is Zoe, her sister, who wears a blue striped shirt all the time. Then there's Alex in her pink striped shirt. And then there's her mom, who has this like purple dry fit that she runs in a lot. So this is like very accurate. You guys don't fully understand the accuracy. This is just Alex. And if you can see, she's got her stripes, and that's a nightgown actually. And then on the left and the right foot, you'll see a red sock and a pink sock. So take note. So this is Alex in said nightgown. There's one that says Alexandra on it. And then there's one that says Zoitza, which is a nickname for Zoe. And there it is, the pink and the red sock. I mean, when I say uniform, I don't even think it does it justice. They it's like literally her skin at this
that
point.
That first picture of like all of them together, I'm like, I've seen that.
Yeah.
I've definitely seen that.
Anyway, this last one was in this, she was drawing a card for me. And this is the card. So on the top is just like some doodles. And then it's actually, you have to like turn yourself this way to see. So if you do that, you'll see my body is like some sort of red shirt. I've got arms and legs. And then she went out of her way to tell me, and Ansu, this purple, that's your bun. And I was like, okay, I'm feeling this. This makes sense. Yeah. I like it.
Differentiate.
Yeah. So
you have hair and you have a bun. She knows you love your bun.
Yeah. I mean, they actually freak out. When I just deleted that thing. Okay, they actually freak out when I wear my hair down. It's so cute. All right, I'm pinning this again.
Do they?
Yeah. Oh my god, they're like, keep it down. I love it.
Oh, that's cute. I didn't know that.
Oh, you didn't know that?
Seen that?
Yeah. Let me pin this. Boom. Nice. Okay, the pin's back up. Yeah, because they're like, they don't understand. Like, where did it? Where do you hide it?
Where did it go?
But last week, you guys saw that, didn't you? And then now you get to see this. I mean, I did all right.
I mean, it looks fire.
There's some areas I'd like to improve, like the ones you touched, like right
yeah,
here.
Yeah, there's a...
Could have lived without that.
There's a pretty clear line right here where I went jupes.
So, since we're on the topic, the one thing about last week that was so wild after rewatching some of the clips was just how much you didn't trust me. Okay. I couldn't see her face.
Okay.
I thought I was going to
be really comfortable with it. I wasn't. I really wasn't.
Honestly, maybe that's my bigger of the week. But since we're not
how uncomfortable I was. It was more like I also wanted to get in there. Like I wanted to be cutting my
I'm aware.
hair.
You wouldn't let me do anything.
Yeah, and I do know some of the lingo and some
you
of
know
the...
How, I know how it feels. I know how it feels.
I know how it feels. Anyways. All right, so we usually do Bicker of the Week, but this week it's the Bicker of the Week. So what we decided to do is just share some nice things that have been happening for us. Because, you know, we bicker.
Yeah.
But we do some nice stuff, too. So, like, today we got... Well, we our light bulbs have been out in the bathroom.
For, like, 4 years.
But as you guys know, like, you know, well, we don't really go out much. So we order on Amazon. And as you guys probably know, like, Amazon takes forever. So the light bulbs, it's probably been, like, a legit 2 weeks. And it's not, it hasn't been pitch black in there, but it's been very, 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 very dull.
Oh, yeah.
So, got the light bulbs today, and I was kind of doing some stuff. I wasn't really thinking. And Megan usually doesn't take, like, doesn't do the stuff around the house. I'm definitely, like, the, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. And, yeah, I don't know where
she put one light bulb.
I know, she put the, she hasn't changed the light bulb since we've dated. Actually, it's actually, like, a fact.
It's a fact, yeah. Yeah.
And so she changed the light bulb.
I will say, I did.
I did.
So I will say, if I was 3 inches taller, it would have been a lot easier.
That's what everybody says. Look at her. So that was very sweet.
Yeah, I got up there, you know, did the whole
thing. Yeah, and you needed to, did you just go on the sink?
I had to get on the sink for one, and then I had to get the chair because the other ones are like in the other parts of the bathroom.
Yeah. Yeah, it was very cool.
Okay. In the same strain as Bicker of the Week, we did have a Bicker this week.
Wait, what's your nice thing?
I'm getting into it. Yeah, remix. And we got into a little bit of a bicker. It might have even been a bicker plus. And I probably was in the wrong. But I was still, like, I had a couple points where I was just like, yeah, but. And in the end, Sue was just like, you know what? She apologized. She apologized first. She took it all, even though it was my fault. And that was really sweet. Because I just, like, I think... I was, like, just digging in for some reason. I just, like,
blame the Godiva.
I
need blame the Godiva. Shout out to the Godiva. If you know,
you know.
Okay.
Yeah, I needed that.
I feel like that's, you know, that's going to be, like, an every now and then remix, but I feel like people like the bickers better.
Yeah, I mean, everyone's going through their bickers. Listen, we have the same bickers. Whatever bickers we had before, they're still
happening.
Yeah. We're still leaving the, you know, the splashies on.
Okay,
on
we
thing.
Said we weren't going to do
bickers. Sorry, okay. Anyways, they're all still there.
So, yeah. Those are some of our regular segments. Another one is memes of the week. We're gonna do that at the end of the show, but like we had to tease it. This is probably my favorite meme of the week.
You'll die.
It's next level.
It's so fucking good.
All right. It's so good. We're gonna get John on soon, but before we do that, we're gonna have some New York City trivia for Megan.
I'm like equally excited and nervous.
No, it's gonna be so easy. So Megan is like obsessed with New York City. Wow. Every time we go in there, it's like. I feel like I'm like a fifth grade teacher because she's just like, what's that? Where's that? What's that mean? What's this? What's this?
Where are we? What way are we going?
So
what thing are we in? Where are we?
So two of my favorite stories, feel free to jump in, are, so we were like coming, we're actually coming from New Jersey. So we're like entering New York and to the right, we like, she was kind of asking, actually I don't remember the buildup as well. So where she was kind of asking like, what tunnel is this? What is this? Where is that? Where is this? Where is that? Is that over there? Is Jersey over there? Is this the Bronx? Where are we? Constantly. So out of nowhere, she was kind of like, you know, where's Statue of Liberty? Where's this? Where's that? Is that the Empire State Building? Is that? And then we come out and we kind of like finally see everything. And then the Statue of Liberty like comes in our eye line and she goes, oh, well, there she is. Lady Liberty. And I was
literally
like,
just like that.
Literally, like
I was tickled with myself.
Very proud.
There she
it was
is.
A proud. And there she is.
Lady Liberty.
And another,
it was great.
It was great.
I was, honestly, I was like, there she is. Lady fucking Liberty. Statue of Libs.
Do you want to tell the next one?
What's the next one?
This one. I mean, I can.
Oh, easily. God. It was a scene. Okay. We're watching basketball.
Brooklyn Net game.
You know, every team has their, like, city editions or whatever they're called. And the Nets ones are dope. I know it has the, like, Biggie sweater theme. Coogee sweater theme going on. I'm like, got it. Know it. He could have had like a pair of millionaires on. I would have been like, I'm here with this. And I'm like, what's Bet Stewie? I said, what? She was like, what? And I was like, fuck.
It was one of those moments where you go, what? Please repeat that. I need to hear that again.
I was like, what? No.
What's Bed Stewie?
Bed Stewie. I was like, damn it! I did it wrong.
It was very sweet. So then I had to explain, like, the ancient historical meaning of all of the Brooklyn... No, I'm kidding.
Yeah. I mean, how would anyone look at that and think Bed-Stuy?
Yeah, well,
because you just know. Yeah. You just know that's not Bed Stewie. Because that's a scene.
So here we go.
As soon as you said that, I was like...
Oh, no, as soon as you said it. I said, I'm sorry, what?
I know, and then you perked up and I was like, damn!
It was so cute. Okay, are you ready? This is not hard.
Don't
read the paper.
I'm not.
It's not hard. I promise. It's like... Honestly, I didn't know half the answers to these questions. That's what makes it funny.
Okay.
We'll start you with a quick true or false.
Okay.
True or false? Pizza was invented in New York City.
False.
Correct. The Empire State Building has its own zip code. Don't look at the paper.
I'm not looking at the paper, I promise.
Eyes to the people.
I don't cheat.
I'm not looking,
False. It's true. What? At 10118, Empire State Building has its own zip code. Okay, the Empire State Building has never been hit by lightning.
Gotta be false.
True. In fact, it gets hit by lightning 23 times a year.
Wait, that's what I meant. It is hit by lightning.
Okay.
What did you ask?
Has never been.
Yeah, it's false.
Whatever. The Statue of Liberty was a gift from President Grover Cleveland. He was the president at the time.
False. It was a gift from France.
Correct. One in every 38 United States citizens lives in New York City.
True.
Yeah, that's true. That's wild when you think about it.
That is insane.
Anyways. Okay.
I tried to do a little math and then I was like, it's just true.
So all right. I didn't do here that. We go. Regular questions. What's the name of the fish that goes on the bagel?
Lox.
Yes. Okay.
Bagel lox.
What's this?
Oh, the basketball player with the gap and the gap, the double gap.
Oh,
pull it.
Larry.
Yes.
Johnson.
Yes.
Good job.
Larry Johnson. He was in those commercials with Muggsy Bogues.
Muggsy what?
Bogues?
Bogues, yeah.
Yeah.
He also played for Charlotte.
Okay. Yeah.
He did. You're right. What commercials? The Grandmamas?
I can't remember.
Okay. Do you know which Nick Biggie's talking about in the I've Got a Story to Tell song?
Because
John's coming on.
I'm new to this story.
John's coming on, so we might ask him.
I'm new to this story.
Do you want
to
give a guess?
Well, what... Okay. I mean...
RJ Barrett.
Yeah.
Right. Speaking of...
Lynn. Sanity.
Speaking of John Starks, what four movies has he been in?
He's been in movies?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, I mean, I have no idea.
Okay.
Last Dance.
Eddie? Should have gotten that one. Whoopi Goldberg? Okay. Eddie,
you know,
Forget Paris, Arliss, and he was an extra in Winner Takes All. I don't know if that really counts, so we'll say 3.5. All right, what two teams play in the Subway Series?
Okay, I know this because...
All right, you're on a clock,
It
so.
Is the Mets and the Yankees.
Yes, good job. That is correct. What does a ticker tape parade mean?
Ooh, ticker tape is like printed out and then it was all shredded up and people threw it out of the windows.
Correct.
Is ticker tape from Wall Street?
Yeah, correct.
Okay.
That's what they printed like all the stuff on.
All right,
name three teams who have gotten a ticker tape parade.
Teams?
Mm-hmm. You can humble brag.
The Giants?
Mm-hmm.
Us?
Mm-hmm.
Twice. I mean, the Rangers?
Yes. New York City has over 10
Wait,
nicknames.
Other teams that have won in New York haven't
Yeah, the,
gotten,
the Rangers.
Haven't
or what'd
gotten.
You say? The Giants, the Yankees,
the other
and the
teams
Rangers.
That have won in New York haven't gotten parades? Or no other team?
No other teams, just New York teams. And then there's been like some Olympic stuff happening.
Like Yankees
and
Yankees.
It's usually like when the war ends, they do it. Yeah, the Yankees did. I just said that.
Did I just say that?
Okay. New York City has over 10 nicknames. Name three of them.
The Big Apple.
Mm-hmm.
The City That Never Sleeps.
Yes. That's why I didn't say it earlier.
Oh my goodness. I don't know.
What?
Wow.
Really?
I don't know.
Okay.
What are
the one? The one I definitely would have said is Gotham.
Oh, dang it.
The one I didn't know was, I mean, it's not no or not no, I wouldn't have pulled it, is the City of Dreams. The other ones I would have gotten, The City's So Nice, they named it twice. Because when you live in New York, you live in New York, New York.
New York, New York.
The Melting Pot, the Five Boroughs, and then Empire City. Okay, how many boroughs are in New York City?
I know this, there's five.
Okay, name them.
Well, Manhattan.
Mm-hmm.
Long Island.
No.
Really?
Really. It can be confusing because there's like two boroughs that are on the actual island, but Long Island's like a different thing. And honestly, I went to school in Queens, and anyone will be quick to tell you that Long Island is not worth it. We know.
Isn't Queens and Long Island?
I just said that. So Manhattan?
I'm going to miss one. Manhattan, Queens,
mm-hmm.
Brooklyn,
mm-hmm.
The Bronx.
Mm-hmm.
I'm
going
to see another one.
It's like another island?
Staten Island. Which I'm like, where is Staten Island?
By Lake Arizona? It's kind of down by Brooklyn. Okay.
That was a setup.
Speaking of Staten Island, what is Staten Island best known for?
I mean, I don't know anything about or what is from Staten Island.
No guess?
Is it food?
No. It's
what?
It smells like shit.
It smells like garbage.
No, they have like landfills.
Nothing redeming.
It's not that. Landfills. No, yeah, they have like I think landfills. And so like anytime you go over the bridge and you're in your car and you've just gotten to Staten Island, it's always this. So it's like it's known for smelling like garbage. That's a real thing. That and like, you know, Method Man.
It's the city's garbage borough.
What is Times Square named after?
The Times? The New York Times?
Yes, that is correct.
Really?
Yeah.
Why would they make something so awful?
I'm sorry, what?
It's crazy.
Why does a billion people go there every year?
Do you?
Okay. No, I avoid it like the plague. But that's because I've been.
It's kooky.
And everybody knows to not go. Okay.
I mean, you gotta go once.
Where is it located?
Times Square?
Uh-huh. Like what, like block?
Midtown.
Okay.
Right in the middle. It is between...
Wait, remember when we went there because we saw a Broadway show with your mom and we like drove in the Uber, drove past an Italian restaurant and she went, are we in Little Italy?
Every 3 seconds she was like,
are we in Little Italy?
Okay. So cute, mom. It's like in the 45s. It's between 5th and 7th in the 45s.
Okay. Close enough.
Ish?
Yeah. Between 42nd and 47th. Between like Broadway and 7th.
Okay.
Okay. Where was Michael Jordan born?
Well, was it Jay-Z said that he was
In the song he just played.
From
honestly, when that lyric
but that
came,
I didn't
I
know
like,
that.
He's I know, from, but where?
Isn't he from Indiana?
I'm sorry, what?
Gary? Isn't he from Gary, Indiana?
Michael Jordan?
Yeah.
No.
He's North from Carolina?
Brooklyn, and then he moved to North Carolina.
Really?
Yeah. Okay.
I didn't know.
I thought for sure because this when the song played, I was like, ugh.
Well, no, that's what I thought, but I was like, I just thought maybe he like had his like, you know, birth.
Okay.
There.
So fill in the blank. Fill in the blank. Spread love. It's the blank way.
Stop looking.
I'm not looking. I'm literally.
Well, you're looking.
No, I'm not.
Spread love. It's the Empire City way.
You really not know?
No. Oh, way.
It's the
Brooklyn way. Dang
okay.
it.
Okay.
Spread love.
It's all right. Brooklyn. Oh, man, I'm not doing what happens?
Be better.
What happens when the Mets hit a home run?
Oh, wait, is this in there?
I'm gonna show everybody.
I have no idea. I mean, they get a do they get a free hot dog or something?
No, this comes out. So
what
is
that?
So this is like from the old. This one's the like OG.
Is that a?
It's like
giant
a hat
tomato.
It's an apple.
Oh, that makes so much sense.
So it's like usually down, but when they hit a home run, the apple comes up. So as like a kid, super hype at Shea Stadium.
Wait.
So now it sits outside Citi Field.
Oh,
I think
it
they
was
have
in
one in
Shea?
There, yeah, in Shea Stadium.
Where?
Like in the back, like in the outfield.
Okay, where and they so put like the pools now?
There is no, you know, Shea Stadium now.
Well, I know it's Citi Field, but you know how some of those stadiums have like those nasty pools that people swim in while they watch? Anyways.
I didn't know that.
That's cool. And okay. It just goes...
Yeah.
So that's the answer to that one. That was fine. Okay.
She said tomato.
I know. She did.
What an idiot.
Yeah.
Why would I say tomato?
Okay. These ones are fast. Ready?
Duh.
Are you allowed to honk your horn in New York City?
Yeah.
No. You get fined $350.
No.
Are you allowed to fart in a New York City church?
Should be able to.
No. It's a misdemeanor. Are women allowed to go topless in New York City?
Yeah.
Yes, they are.
They are.
That is correct.
Not okay. Shocking.
What is a bridge and tunnel person?
That's a person from Long Island.
Okay, keep going, keep going.
Or somewhere else.
It's true.
From somewhere else that comes and parties in the city, but like can't live there.
That's, yeah.
Doesn't live there.
That is true. It's also people who like come in for work, come in for entertainment, come in for this, but don't
this
live.
Is how it has been presented to me.
Yeah, because you, what movie? It's like from a movie, probably.
Okay. More like some Nights Out.
Okay. So are you a Bridge and Tunnel girl?
No.
Yeah, you are.
No,
am you I? Are technically right
more
now.
Right now,
a Bridge and Tunnel girl.
Yeah, I don't want
to
be.
Okay.
I don't want to live there.
Can you name 5 bridges and or tunnels?
Holland, Lincoln.
You just remember.
Brooklyn.
In the butt. In the toilet.
Holland. Winking. Brooklyn.
Brooklyn what?
Bridge.
Okay.
The Verrazano.
I just said that.
There
you go, one more.
The George Washington.
Good job. I was going to give you extra points if you could name one more tunnel, but that didn't happen.
Ooh, there's
okay.
More tunnels?
Yes. Define the following. NoHo.
North of Houston.
SoHo.
South of Houston.
Dumbo.
Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
Right over, right underneath the Brooklyn Bridge.
You're so close.
And it's is an acronym?
Yeah. It's a tough one. So down under the Manhattan Bridge overpass.
Yeah, I just said that.
No, no, you're close. I know, but you want to like nail it.
Yeah.
All right. Nolito.
Nolito is north of Little Italy.
Yes. And speaking of Little Italy, where's the real Little Italy? Ryan, if you're watching, you're going to appreciate this one. Hint.
Well,
we ate there.
Away up north by Fordham?
Yes!
Really?
The Bronx, on North Ave. Yeah, well, like that area. Yeah.
Yes.
Good job. I'm impressed. Okay.
But the one down further in like lower Manhattan, it says Little Italy.
I know, but some people say that the one in the Bronx is the real Little Italy. All
right.
Whatever.
Okay. Wherever we ate was really good.
If you're going from SoHo to the Upper West Side, are you taking a subway or a train?
Okay, SoHo to the Upper West, you're taking the subway.
Okay. And if you're going from Penn Station to Syosset, are you taking the subway or the train?
You're taking the train.
Good job. What does LIRR stand for?
Long Island Rail Road.
Boom. How much does the Naked Cowboy make a year? This was a bit, I don't want to lead you.
Like $1 million?
No, no, no.
$250,000.
$150,000. See, I should have, I led you a little bit.
Okay.
That one, you get like half a point.
Well, okay. You know, growing up, this is what I heard about New York City, that people just like pretend like they're homeless in New York City, but actually they're millionaires. And I was like, I think that's a way to disparage people that don't have homes, but okay.
Okay. Why are skyscrapers mostly located in Midtown and Lower Manhattan?
There's building codes. Higher.
Elaborate.
There's, I think in Upper Manhattan, people were settled there earlier, and so there was lower places. And
I'm
then
just
going to
cut you
keep,
off. Okay. It's because of like the foundation, like the bedrock can't support it in Upper Manhattan.
I was going. With,
I know
like,
you were on like a whole. Honestly,
super,
I don't know when that was.
Yeah,
stop.
It wasn't.
So
it wasn't because I was a little lost in it.
Okay, name
three. It's not like strong enough.
Yeah, that's like a theory. I don't know. It might be a little bit stronger than a theory, but it's like what people have like accepted.
Wow.
But there's like other, you
so
know,
like you can't
conspiracy
get high
theories.
Until like 60.
I don't know the exact number.
Up there. Wow.
You can go check if you can find like
I'm gonna
conglomerate
look,
rock.
I'm gonna look
you can
into
build.
It.
Okay. Name three of the most popular skyscrapers.
Now?
Yeah.
Freedom Tower?
Okay.
World Not really?
Yeah, yeah.
World Trade, old World Trades, new World
That's
Trade.
Twin Towers. Yeah.
Twin Towers.
No, Freedom Towers.
I mean, Empire State Building.
No, you're making me.
Oh, yeah. MetLife.
Yeah.
Building.
Mm-hmm. That counts.
No,
that was three. Okay, so the next question is picture. So which one is this?
Ooh. That
Looks a lot.
It's not a trick question.
Like the Empire State Building.
No.
It's the Chrysler Building. Dang it! I knew it wasn't it.
Tried to get her.
Okay. Looking at me.
Okay. Two truths and a lie. I don't know which truths.
Okay.
Which was invented in New York City? Two truths, one lie.
Okay.
Was it cheesecake, ice cream cones, eggs benedict?
Cheesecake and eggs benedict.
Incorrect. Cheesecake was not invented in New York. Ice cream cones, eggs benedict, and there's actually a third one that I read about.
Really?
Pasta primavera. Who knew?
Wow.
Okay, what neighborhood did Friends take place in?
Central Park.
No. West Village. What was the name of the coffee shop?
Central Park.
Right.
That's
where did Jerry Seinfeld live?
I have no idea, actually.
You could probably guess, actually.
So...
No. You can't. Upper West Side. Where did George's family live?
Lower East Side.
Queens. Where was the Soup Nazi located?
The Soup Nazi. In Brooklyn? No, because it would have been in Manhattan. So it would have been...
Have you seen that episode?
Yes.
Okay.
No soup for you. I don't know.
Okay. Midtown. So you know what the Soup Nazi is then. All right,
I thought Midtown because working people are going in to get their soup.
Okay. Yeah. What expressway is unbeatable?
Oh.
You know this. I want to give you a hint, but it'll be too obvious.
The Van Wyck.
Good job.
JFK. Okay. To where
I actually was like the other day, I was like, do you know what the Van Wyck is? She's like, yeah, it's the one you take to JFK. Yeah. I was like, oh, my.
I don't know like exactly where it takes
go.
Us, but
okay. Name three modes of transportation you can take to get to the Hamptons from New York City.
Helicopter.
Okay, yes, that is true.
Yes.
Assuming you're on a budget.
Okay.
What are the three that you can take?
Can you take a ferry?
Nope. I mean, honestly, I don't know.
Okay, probably well, you not. Can drive.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, there's obvious ones.
You can take the LIRR.
Okay, yes.
What else?
The jitney.
The jitney?
The jitney.
The fuck is the jitney? Wait, what?
Everybody who knows the jitney, who have been on the jitney, they know.
Wait,
okay. What? No cell phones on the jitney. Okay. Name three colleges located in New York City.
Fordham, NYU, and Columbia.
Okay. What is Gray's papaya?
No idea, but I like papaya.
Hot dogs. How many Walmarts are located in New York City?
Zero.
Hey, how'd you know that?
Because even Walmart isn't rich enough to put that big shit in New York City.
That is not... You didn't save the number. That is not...
Yeah,
you did? Okay. That is not the reason.
Nobody can afford that much space in New York City.
No.
Walmart probably could. Nobody wants Walmart in New York City. Why is it?
So Walmart doesn't unionize its employees, and New York City has a rule that you have to unionize.
Good job, New York.
All right, we're almost done. Do I let you drive when we go to New York City?
Never. Not okay. One time.
Final question. Netflix and chill, Ghost, or Wife Up? Gloria Steinem, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, AOC.
Ah! Oh my God. Ah! Okay. I'm going to marry AOC.
Oh, you're going to wife her?
I'm going to wife
Use
her up.
Use the lingo.
Frankly, she's going to be around the longest.
You really put yourself in a bind here, didn't you?
I sure did. Okay. Ugh. Oh my God. I'm gonna ghost Gloria only because I know she's so busy she probably wouldn't notice, and I'm gonna Netflix and chill with RBG.
Well, you can't, yeah, you can't ghost RBG.
You can't. I mean, I should marry her, but she's married already. But, you know, God, that was tough. That was a dirty trick.
Well, you survived. Congratulations.
That was good. You know, I'm learning. Every day I learn about New York City. I love it. All the time.
So yeah, real fast.
That's a good one. I love it.
John's in the building. We're going to do our own little quick Last Dance review. It's obviously over now. So Megan, give us one takeaway.
Oh my gosh. Dennis Rodman is a fucking legend. I mean, style, like, I'm really into fashion and do watch it. He's insane and, like, was so out there for his time. Incredible. And then, like, the Bulls and Jordan were as lit as I felt that they were at the age that I watched them. It was even, like, more. Like, watching Michael Jordan, like, just, there is no other figure like them. He's, like, gorgeous and athletic and, like, smart and funny and doing all these, like, funny thing or, like, incredible thing. And he was just, like, unlike anyone we've ever seen. And no one has been like him since. And it was as amazing as I felt it as a child as it was watching it again.
Good one, good one.
So
but
for
mostly
me,
Dennis Rodman.
Okay. Even
so for
it's
me,
gone off the rails a little bit. So for me, it was when, there's so many, when Toni Kukoc turned down an NBA contract because he was going to make more in Europe. I was like, dang. And I went and Googled all the numbers. I'm not going to bore you, but basically it's like, it just goes to show you that when Michael Jordan, or it goes to show you Michael Jordan's impact on like the finance and just like the business aspect of the NBA. Like he made it boom. Like he wasn't even making the crazy contracts we see now. So all of a sudden he started it and now it's like no European player. And don't get me wrong, there's like life reasons why you turn down an NBA contract. You know, like you don't want to travel as much or there's too many games, that stuff. But from a pure that's
money
crazy.
Standpoint, nobody turns down like a great contract.
He literally
so
has
so
like
crazy.
Multiple billion dollar businesses that are like.
Yeah. No. That's
like,
off the court's another thing.
To him,
I'm not even talking about off the court.
Like the NBA.
I'm just talking about
like
one thing.
What it is,
I mean,
plus,
it all impacts.
Yeah.
But. It's wild. And then last, so what my other thing was, I was just like, after they won in 98, I was like, why are they still in their uniforms? Like they won, they champagne, they have their shirts on, the hats, and then you see them get on the bus with like that. We've all won championships.
Yeah.
It's like you shower or change or something. It's like
yeah, not in your uniform.
So I was very obsessed with, I mean you're not in your uniform all night. I was very obsessed with this, unless you're Marcy Zell and you lost and you don't want to take it off. And so I actually got the opportunity to ask the question. It was to Ahmad originally, because we were doing like a little thing for Gatorade. And then Ron hit me with some knowledge. Too much champagne.
Too much champagne.
And a lot more on the plane. And I was like, that makes sense.
Respect
so you're
that.
Either too drunk to change. Respect. You're either too, your clothes got soaked. Can't put
yeah.
them on.
Can't put them on.
Amazing. I was very happy to learn that. All right, guys. It's time.
It's fucking time.
It's time. So before we get him in, we want to share something with you. I got to find it.
I mean,
we're high tech, but we're not that high tech. So this is like,
it's gotta be one of the most satisfying dunks ever.
This song right here, like, is my AAU childhood.
We are the New York Knicks.
Get ready, John.
We are the New York Knicks. We are the New York Knicks. Say go New York, go New York, go.
Look at that camera angle.
Hardcore, and I'll tell
that.
You like this, we ain't
never looked sharp. We had an outfit change, we had costume change, we had wardrobe.
Let's enjoy the song. We're back on pace, everyone's gearing up for the championship race, and the fans are going crazy, and they're doing it for a reason. Cause 94 is the nick of the season. You better believe that it's got all that takes. We're shooting 3 pointers, and we're running fast breaks, and if your defense makes a mistake, then bam, you ain't dunks in your face. This is a team you don't want to miss. We are New York, we are the New York Knicks. Go New York, go New York, go.
Oh, there he was.
And no rebounds. If that's the case, we put Oakley a mace in your face. We draw charges and we set picks. We are New York. We are the New York Knicks. Say go New York, go New York, go. Go New York, go New York, go. Say go New York, go New York, go. Go New York, go New York, go.
There it is, folks. The song. We're gonna give him a proper intro when he gets in here, but let me find him first.
Don't you worry.
Is that the one? There he is.
Boom.
Get him in.
Get him in.
I'm excited.
Oh, I forgot to show my hate tweets. Oh, I forgot to show that video. Oh, whatever. Waiting for New York Knicks to respond. Oh, I can't show pictures now. So actually, I'll say this. So on The Last Dance, for those that watched, there was a clip where I was telling my favorite, like, the actual question was, what's your favorite Michael Jordan memory? And I was like, well, I kind of have one, but it's not my favorite, but it is. And it's the dunk. And my take on it is that John Starks dunked on Michael Jordan. And I know Horace Grant was there, and I know what getting dunked on means.
Was he even there?
He was there.
No one talks about him like he was.
So the hate tweets I got were like something else. I was like, dang. Oh, I don't have it on here. I'll have to show it on there. I'll show you after when he cuts off. But yeah, so that's kind of like my memory and thought of like the Knicks, John Starks, that era. I have so many stories. Like even the Go New York song, it was like, all right, it didn't work that time. Let's try again.
Yeah, that's like, that was like your hometown team.
Yeah, no, I'm saying, but AAU, we would like sing the Go New York song. We like had it on tape. Dang. Somebody probably like maybe copied it off. I don't know, maybe dubbed it off the radio or something.
Did someone?
And someone probably was me. Not doctored up. We would just like insert our names and stuff and just sing, go New York, go New York, go.
I love that.
Okay. All right. There he is. Boom. Add. Boom. Hopefully it works this time. Add. So yeah, that's like. Yeah, growing up, it's like all I did. My first professional game was at the Garden. It was actually against the Knicks were playing the Bulls, and I remember it. I think I was like 5 or 6, and I remember
it. Whoa, really?
Yeah, no, I was young. Yeah, remember I called my dad, and I was like, Dad, yeah. I'm remembering this right? And I was.
That's pretty dope.
As it turns out.
So yeah. It was like.
It was Jordan's second year, so I think year, I was. Yeah. I have a late birthday, so it's kind of, I think I was like 5 or 6.
Oh my God, how cute.
So yeah, now we're just waiting on John. Okay. It says waiting.
So we can get him in.
Yeah.
I don't know.
We're going to give a text and see what happens. In the meantime.
Yeah, if you don't have a text,
guys, I'm so excited for the memes later. They're so good. Okay, Fagan wants to know, what's your favorite Starks memory?
Mine?
Yeah.
I mean, you gotta say the dunk for sure. I grew up a Bulls fan, and so I like totally remember those series. But isn't it? It's like I always feel like the coolest thing about John Starks was that like he was like this like individual figure who, you know, wasn't like the best player, but like a great player. And he just like carved out this space for himself that like he was able to like thrive and excel in. And like, I always just found that so cool. I think a lot of people are just like, oh, whatever. Like, you know, I'm just going to come out here and like do my job. But he was like, no, I'm coming out here and like, I'm going to, you know, dunk on you, or I'm going to like do whatever I can, or I'm going to like, you know, be that sort of like instigator. I'm going to like, that was kind of his game, but also like his personality. And he like carved out this like, pretty significant piece of like NBA history. I don't know.
No, I know.
He had like a.
Sorry, guys.
No, he totally had a cool following.
Awesome. Yeah. No, I know. But like,
he's just like talking off, shit like, to everyone. Like, that was great.
He said New York Knicks unable to join.
I know.
And oh, they're gone now. Okay, maybe he'll come back. No. So I have an idea. I'm gonna show what I want to show until he comes back.
Okay.
So this is the video that I was talking about, the dunk. And like I said, there was a lot of hate tweets. The one that, you know, really hurt me because I like Sarah. And, you know, apparently she liked me, but it's now past tense. But then if you see what next person, Alex from the block, wrote, I was like, that's pretty funny. Because it's true. When we're a Knicks fan, we let you know. All right. So we think he's in the building now.
Let's see what happens. Set that off. Boom, boom. There they are. We are the New York Knicks. Starks.
Won't connect. Go, New York. Go, New York. Go. Do, do,
do. I don't know what's going on.
Hey.
Hmm.
There was no sound?
Should you tell it?
So basically, what I said was, I basically said, like, growing up, huge Knicks fan, whatever, 93 conference finals, Knicks are up 2-0 because in this game, John dunks on Jordan, as we all know. And then I just kind of joked where it was like, you probably don't want to piss off Jordan. And then what happened was, you know, the Knicks kind of, I'm not going to say they blew it. I'm going to say the Bulls then went on to like,
Knicks were unable to join. And that one, was that when they were talking about.
You
want to
go on yours and see if you can get on that?
Yeah. Was that when they were talking about Michael Jordan going and doing the gambling?
Yeah, that's exactly
the gambling. So the New York media probably ruined it for the Knicks. That's probably what happened. They got all involved. Oh, look, we have a story.
All right, we're having technical difficulties.
Want to try?
Yeah, I mean, it says it's the Knicks. But then we have to tell them to go. Maybe not. Maybe just,
yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see. We'll just give it a.
Yeah, we'll wait for them one more time.
Give it a minute.
They're in there. Yeah, I know they are in there. Boom. Oh, they're unable to join. Okay, go on yours.
Hmm.
All right. Switching over. Don't switch yet, though, because we got to see if he gets on first. Like, you know what I mean? I'm going to be like, boo-boo. Actually, do what you want, because you'll know regardless.
All right. We're live. We're still live. Don't worry. It's still both of us. And Starman.
You've got one.
Got one follower. Just increasing rapidly. Okay.
Let's see if we can find.
Who wants to listen to some music, though?
Yeah, we got your playlist.
I literally
had
so much fun making this. And this is one of my favorite Nas songs.
Listen up, gangsters and honeys, with your hair done. Pull up a chair, honey.
Do they know to go? Yeah, I started. Okay.
So we'll just wait. The homies come in.
Nope, they're out of there.
I mean, who doesn't love a little technical difficulty in quarantine times?
No, I know.
I mean, actually, we should do some questions. We're here. We're chilling. We'll see what people got.
Okay, I'll wait and see.
Oh, these are the questions from when I posted. You guys just write in questions. I have a question. All right, Daniela. Song request? We could do song requests.
New York only.
No. Yeah. So, like, they're, you know. This is actually in the playlist. So, this is really just, we aren't here. I gotta just put it here. And that's like insane. All right, New York State of Mind. Bop, 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 bop. That was the ball club, wasn't it? Yeah, it was. Ball club, club. I think he might come back in here one more time. Okay. I actually don't know if he's coming in. Oh. We'll get to all of those. These are good requests, though. Coming back to yours. Just wait for John. We're gonna find him. It's always a tech difficulty. In the meantime, the funny thing is like it's trapped. That you can text this. I mean, test this, and it still doesn't matter. Come game time, always something.
Doesn't matter.
There's always something. Check it again. I don't think so. Okay, they said they're gonna try yours. Okay. Turn your brightness up.
Yeah.
Ooh, the battery's not the best. Here, you wanna use that? Here you go.
Yeah, but
there you go. Well, I'm gonna put it in there.
Yeah,
once we get it. Okay. All right, what's your favorite restaurant in New York? Good question.
I love Charlie Bird.
Yeah. Charlie Bird's so bomb.
Super cute neighborhood.
People are amazing. We've had a big dinner there. I've gone there by myself, done like a bar sit situation. Yeah, they're awesome. The food's like ridiculous.
Yeah, so good.
What else? What other place? I don't know if I have a repertoire like that yet.
Just Charlie Bird?
What was it? Charlie Bird's up there.
The pizza is really what they say it is.
It's legit.
Yeah,
and then, what's the pizza place that's like their partner, like their sister restaurant? It starts with a P.
Oh, Pasquale Jones.
Yes, yeah.
Pasquale Jones is fire.
So good.
Yeah, Pasquale is fire.
Love the haircut.
I don't know if you know, but Sue's
guys, you have such good questions for John. I'm so excited for this.
We can't wait. It's going to be great.
I love that I played a video and there was no volume on it.
Just
okay. It's okay, yeah.
I know.
Sue spends, who can do the most push-ups?
I love him, Sue. That's how I'm laughing. I wouldn't dare try to do a push-up competition. Actually, you wouldn't either.
I don't think anyone's
still on request. They said that he's commenting. So try to catch it in there.
Okay. Can't you just like search for people in here?
Can you?
I don't know.
Oh yeah, you tried that once.
Yeah.
I mean, usually we keep a show moving.
No, you did not miss Starks. We're trying to get him on.
No.
It's again, coming.
Oh, there it is.
Okay.
Go live.
Okay.
I don't think it's going to work. Come on, internet. Don't fail us now.
Still just says waiting.
Do you guys want to see what we're looking at?
Wait.
Hold it up a little bit. Yeah. Nike boxes. Yeah. And cleats. What a bum.
Yeah.
Sometimes this happens though.
Yeah, how weird.
Should we play Give Me a Reason by ourselves of John's?
Yeah.
Of his.
Okay.
Yes, you know.
Try it a few other
guys,
times.
Good things. Honestly, stay for the memes if you do anything. Stay for the
They're
memes.
Ridiculous.
I'm like, I usually don't hype it up like this.
Yeah, it's so, we're very excited.
It's dumb this week. It's so good. It's so funny.
Okay, it says waiting.
Maybe FaceTime him.
Yeah, right.
He came up green though. All right, next request. Anyone?
Weird. I wonder what it is. I'm always like, what is the technical difficulty? Dining. What is the actual difficulty in the technical aspects? You know what
Who
I mean?
Knows?
I mean, I don't get it. I don't get how this is even happening. So, Empire State of Mind.
Ooh, Big Pun. I might have to go Big Pun.
Get it.
But which one? I mean, is this too obvious? Is this a too obvious Big Pun song? Should we just have a DJ party?
Yeah.
I mean,
try him.
All right.
I'm requesting
song number one. Song number two. Here we go. I'm just gonna delete this bit off. So. We have it all here. This is like top three.
You can catch me in a Chevy red one.
Big Pun. That's what Marie goes. Big Pun reminds me of Brad. Brad goes, thank you.
Thanks.
I would love to tell you guys what we were gonna ask him, but this is gonna happen at some point in my life, so I can't.
We can't waste it.
We need the man.
I know.
Yeah, we can't just ask the questions without the I got my shirt on and everything. So we won this shirt. We caught this shirt at a Nick game. Do you remember?
Yeah, we did.
You're right. Yeah. I've actually, what have I been?
Girl, two times.
With Mia.
Yeah.
I've been there. Okay?
No, I think just.
Yeah, only two times.
I was like,
yeah, we saw the Spurs.
I have no idea who played or who won the games.
Probably the Knicks.
Yeah.
All right, next artist. I'll get him set up. All right, Knicks are in here.
All right, we're back.
Try again.
We're back.
Call Gino for help. It's probably like a setting, or maybe it's just like IG on Saturdays. All right, we got I see a Method Man in there. Should we go Method Man? All right. Do you have any say in this?
I think I better abstain from this activity.
Okay, song number one.
For no more embarrassing moments.
This is song number one.
Yeah, yeah.
This is one. Ooh. Which one?
Just have you close it out.
Maybe. Close it out, come back in. One or two? One or two? I see a lot of ones, but you haven't heard two yet. What are you doing?
Well, I was trying to find them again.
I'm seeing only ones. Hmm. Redman's from New Jersey, Brad. One? I respect it. Ooh, Teddy with the two. I know Teddy.
Teddy!
All right. We're trying to get John on another handle. Let's see if it works. See it? What is it? John Stark's Foundation.
Oh, okay.
Keep it on the lookout. Good
job on the playlist, babe.
I'm gonna go the locks. Number one. Or number two. I'm keeping number two on. We can do Q&A. Throw some. throw some questions out there.
The RZA, the GZA.
My best every week. I don't know what's going on. Shimmy, shimmy, y'all. Yeah. Old Dirty. No, Method Man's probably my favorite. There we go. I see him. I see him.
This folks, be it.
It could just be Instagram tonight, too. If this doesn't work, who knows?
Instagram would.
Should I try to get off the weekly?
I think that's it. Everything's coming up.
I know. Could we get on either?
Oh,
yeah.
That's weird. Yeah, Weebly seems fine.
Seems like a technical thing, not even like a service thing. I don't know. Seems like an algorithm.
You should try
to get on.
I was just trying to get on.
Oh, yeah. Maybe if you can't get anyone on.
I know. I know.
Let me see.
You're going to try?
Is it going to be like, wah, wah,
yes.
Wah? Okay, well, let's just try.
Request it. Right there. Request. Yeah. Well, I think I have to. All right, I'll cancel this. Oh, you're in there. Turn your volume down. It's down. It's Instagram. Oh, no, it's connected.
Shut up, shut up.
Get out. All right.
Leave.
So listen. I don't know what's happening. There's technical stuff happening. Oh, he's unable to join. Okay, and it happens. We move on. I feel like we could just, this night I'm with the memes.
In honor of John Starks.
Oh, 100%.
100%.
100%. And you know what? You guys couldn't hear my interview and it was like so perfect, so maybe that's why. What's
that? That was the dunk.
Oh.
Yeah. With my left hand, though.
I know, he does dunk a lot with his left hand.
Yeah.
It's crazy. All right, let's see if he's here. I feel like I'm just going to keep requesting him.
It's, I mean, technical difficulties are just, like, it's really no one's fault except the developers at Instagram.
Yeah. I mean, whose fault is it? Who knows? I mean, it happens.
All right.
You know, I think about it. We've had, this is our 10th episode, number 10.
Really?
Yes. That means, you know, I know, I'm high-fiving. Can we also do, like, a
10 weeks.
Just like a, I was just going to say that. I'm like, we also just have like a whatever the opposite of a high five is.
One of these
10 weeks. Although also high five, we've made it 10 weeks. We've all made it 10 weeks. So anyways.
Now everything's opening back up.
I'm gonna put this in my folder. Like we were gonna ask him questions like, you know what? These were the fan questions. Teddy, shout out. What was the locker room after what was the locker room like after Biggie dropped I Got a Story to Tell? Classic.
Good one. Good.
AA underscore sure said, asked, have you ever reminded MJ of the dunk? All things I was dying to know.
I would do that all the time.
And no, you wouldn't.
Yeah.
So like when you like see the Japanese players, you're like, remember I made that cross and Abby.
No, that's different.
Why?
Because like Michael Jordan's like Michael Jordan, you know? So it's like any one dig you have in him.
I think Naha would have a problem with that.
I'm not Michael Jordan.
No, I know.
Or Namu's not Michael Jordan.
From what you told me in Japan, Namu is Michael Jordan.
Legend, as everyone knows. But I don't know, it's just a little different. It's like anyone who can get a dig in over Michael, you should.
Yeah, no, that's true, that's true. This is reminding me of the days when we didn't have guests. We only went 45 minutes. Remember that 9 weeks ago? Boring.
Blessed.
Boring. I know.
The 45 minutes lasted, literally, 45 minutes, that's it. And never went into another show. Once D blew it out of the water, we were like, oh my god, we can go as long as we want. Amazing. Okay.
Do you have any other fan questions? For John Starks?
No.
There's some in here, but they're all, you know, John Starks-centric.
Right here it says react to interview.
Where do we find the playlist?
Great.
Spotify.
Spotify.
A Touch More.
A Touch More on Spotify. No spaces, right?
All right. Favorite Megan tattoo? You answer, and then I'll answer.
Ooh.
I'm gonna
have that many.
Two little guys.
Ah! This is hard. Oh, goodness. I know they all mean so much. They're all, like, fun and cute. And, on the side.
More?
More. Tough. I really like this one. This is, like, for my little nephew, Austin. That's an A. My little bro. Love him. This I got with Rach and Lori. It's a friend's one. This is a friend's one, too. So that was fun. Road trips. This one's, like,
wait,
for my family.
Because then I have to pick one.
Oh, okay. Oh, you didn't want a detailed description of all of them?
Okay.
They probably do, actually.
I'll pick my favorite. Go ahead. It's out there. I'm done.
So I think my favorite is the California one. I just see it the most. Not because I like California. But this one is also my favorite.
Go ahead.
Okay. So my older sister, Jimmy, she might be on here right now. Drop a comment if you are. And rude if you are. And we were kind of like, oh, we should all, like, you know, the women in the family, we should, like, all get tattoos and, you know, yada yada, like, sisters. It's like me, Jenny, Rach, Zay, and my mom. And my mom's like, I'm not getting a tattoo. And we were like, okay, she will, you know, like, she's not going to. And so we've been talking about it for a while, women, warrior women, strong women, like, we have, you know, a family full of strong women, yada yada. So we were kind of throwing around designs. I'm like, well, you know, we don't really need to all get the same exact one. And so I just went and got my own and basically got, you know, a W, which obviously if you put it up, looks a lot like an M. So that's my name. So that's not, you know, so people are like, oh, is that an M? And I'm like, no, it's not an M. It's basically a W for family that I got on my own and no one else in the family has it. So yeah. Just went with it. I'm like, hey guys, I got my tattoo.
I just love this.
Whenever
story,
you're ready, go
sweet.
Ahead and get yours.
But Jenny did get one.
Yeah, Jenny got one. Yeah.
No, yeah, I just love the story.
So Rach funny. Hasn't gotten hers yet, and Mammers hasn't gotten hers yet. So,
it's rude.
Yeah.
Mammers.
Yeah, and it's like it's you. It's yeah. like so you. Yeah. I mean, they're all like super cute because they just kind of like
yeah, they're just like little spots.
Yeah,
they're like little bracelets.
Yeah, I like the tattoos. Okay. Back to the cues. Someone just said favorite date night. I think in New York City. I think it's Charlie Bird for sure.
Yeah, Charlie Bird, New York City. Anywhere in New York City, to be honest. Like, if you eat at a bad restaurant in New York City, you've like massively failed. So many.
Ooh,
places.
This is a good one.
What will you?
What
leave
do you think?
Will you ladies still do this? Ooh,
it's a good question.
I know. What do you think? I mean, I've actually thought about this.
What have you thought?
Well, maybe.
Prime time. So we can curse?
Yeah. Prime time, later hour.
Oh, prime time.
I think it's shown us that we do like doing this, that maybe some kind of TV show would be cool. Yeah. I mean, I don't know if he's going to actually give us one, but yeah. I'm into it. I like it. I mean, obviously, as we, you know, start getting out of quarantine and, like, things go back to, I won't say normal, there's no more normal, but as we, you know, are able to step out a little bit more, I guess we'll have less time for it. But honestly, I don't think anybody's stepping out anytime soon, like, stepping out, like, in back into, like, the world. So we could, if we do it remotely, then, like, we are the guests. So then we couldn't have guests on. So I like that we're together and then we can bring someone else on.
Oh, us remote. Yeah. So I'm still trying to troubleshoot the John Stark situation. So I didn't hear the exact thing you said.
Oh,
but yeah, no, we should definitely think about it. Okay. You rocked on the L word. I know, Chelsea, I've been slipping. All right. They think they fixed it.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay, he's not in there now, but he's coming back.
Oh,
so
gosh, yes.
This is it, guys.
What was the difficulty?
They don't know yet. And enough with the Knicks jokes and the John Starks jokes.
Okay, people.
Okay.
Should I just take a quick bathroom break?
Yeah.
Right back. Quick bathroom break.
always leave them. I honestly, when these moments happen, I feel like Garth in Wayne's World when Wayne leaves. I'm like,
Wayne.
All right, I'm gonna check, see if he's in there. Not yet. What country do you want to travel to? I've never been to Amsterdam, and that's like a really like high on the list. It's been on the high on my list for a long time. Do you have a direct line to the IG live tech support? Yes. No, we're talking to like people at the Knicks, talking to John on tech, trying to figure it out. You know how it is. What's everyone do when this happens? You gotta restart. Do a little restart, figure it out. Yankees or Mets? Mets. That's a no-brainer. All right, let me see what other... Wayne!
Wayne, tomorrow.
How's it going?
You getting them in?
Good. They are figured out. All right, let's see if they're in there now. He's in there now. Yeah. Not yet.
Give me some more.
All right. Honestly, making this playlist, Busta Rhymes, he's like so many.
Yeah, he was good. And he'd like,
we want a little Mason, fish eye. Some Mason camera.
He pioneered that fisheye camera for all his videos. It was great.
Islanders. Everyone's saying you broke the seal.
Yeah.
I don't see him in there. To the top.
I'll wait.
What are your favorite sneakers at the moment? So I was actually a huge Dunk fan, like always.
I have like a lot of
always me. Yeah. But you've seen, yeah. I have a lot of like the just ones like OG, meaning like when they came out, like early to middle, I guess. Yeah, like middle 2000s. So now that they're like coming back, Dunks are high on the list.
Do you have like a couple of tubs of Dunks in the?
No, not like that many. This is gonna be really. I threw a lot out. I gave them to Goodwill one year. I was cleaning out my. Yeah, it was kind of just like basic ones. I kept all the like the De La Soul ones. I guess I don't even know if they're called Tiffany ones. But, like some of those like yeah. You know like more like yeah. But yeah, like plain old ones. I had to get rid of. Ooh, John Starks Foundation is here. You commented. I keep saying they for him. John, comment again. I didn't
worry. We're on it and we're looking.
I know you can't. You have to do it. He didn't request there, so you have to. That was a good one, Lauren. Nothing. All right. I'm looking for John Starks Foundation. Let's see it. How do you know he's in here if he didn't comment? Mm-hmm. How do people know he's in here if he didn't comment? Can you like look, see who's in there? I have no idea. Can you push on that thing above that shows how many people? All right, John, hit me with a comment if you are indeed in here.
If you were in the
He didn't comment. Thank you. His comment is above mine. Where is yours? Go be for a go be. Oh, wait, go back up. Oh, no, somebody just commented that. Okay. All right, I can't be scrolling. It's too. No, I was watching. I didn't see anything. Okay, we're going to the beginning. Obsessed with Starks. Someone else said he commented. Oh, he commented a long time ago. Oh, there he is. He requested. All right, guys. Everybody, cross your fingers.
chosen, but I'll take it. John, can you hear us?
John, I got you happy. He's in a really well-lit area. I appreciate that. Yeah. In this hour.
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah.
Can you hear us?
Oh, no, that's better.
Yeah. That's better?
Oh, okay. All right.
A lot better.
We can't see you, but we're just going to roll with this.
You can't see me?
No, you're like frozen.
Oh, get out of here. But you can hear me though, right?
Yeah, we can hear you. We can hear you.
Oh, okay. How you guys doing?
We're doing well. How are you?
I'm good.
Tricky Wi-Fi, huh? Gets us every time, honestly. Every week we enter this show, like, I hope this works.
A mess. Every time.
Yeah. I'm barely tech savvy, yeah, savvy as it is. Yeah.
I'm hot. You guys can all see it. I'm hot. No, I'm hot just because it's hot here.
Yeah.
Megan doesn't like air conditioning. So.
I don't. It gets in my sinuses.
Yeah. But yeah, thank you for coming on. So I'm sure you know I'm a huge Nick fan. And, you know, Monday is actually the 27th anniversary of your dunk, of the dunk, yeah, which I had to explain to Megan. I was like, no, it's just actually this one name. It's just the dunk.
Yeah,
it's not like his dunk, John Stark's dunk. Nope, it's just.
I go like full explanation on every time. She's like, no, it's actually just.
I'm like, you
the
can
dunk.
Just say
like,
the dunk.
Okay. I mean, I know it.
And we'll all get it.
I've been doing it all night.
But I actually read somewhere. So is it true that you didn't even know, like, Jordan was in the picture until you saw it the next day?
Yeah, not at all. You know,
for real?
At that time, yeah, you know how it is when you're playing. You're not even focused on how you're doing is completing the play. And I was trying to get a glimpse of it on the big screen while I was sitting on the bench doing a timeout, but I couldn't catch it. And it wasn't until the next day when I saw it in the paper that I knew he was on the back end of that.
Really?
That's why. To me, he was the only person that you dunked on. I feel like people talk about like, oh, was he in there? Was he not? You never hear like, oh, Horace was in there. Nobody ever says that. They just say
Horace Grant. You're right.
Yeah, I'm like, Horace, you're out. They like erased him from the poster and like put Michael closer.
There are some people that have done that. But there's actually a really good angle where it's like Horace's goggles like have come off his face. And I'm like, you know what? That right there might be even worth it. It might be better than MJ. He's knocked the guy's goggles off.
Yeah, he's out.
Yeah, that was a wicked, wicked picture. I've seen that. That was a pretty
cool picture. Oh, it's so good. So did you watch, have you been watching Last Dance?
Yeah, I have. It's been great, actually.
Yeah, what do you think? Like, have you been loving it? Like, what do you think about it?
Yeah, I have, you know, because, you know, when you're immersed in the battles against them and you don't really see the behind-the-scenes, you know, things that went on with Chicago, with Michael and all the rest of the players, it's been pretty cool just to get the insights on, you know, what made him great and what made that team a special team, especially during that era. And
so, yeah, and you guys were like such a big part of that too. You were like antagonist, like number one in that era. So that must have been cool to like, you know, see the little digs coming back and like all the rivalry and everything.
Oh, no question. You know, it's been fun just to kind of relive those moments and the battles that we had with them. Obviously, you know, they was a team that, you know, everybody was gunning for during that time, and you had to get through them if you wanted to accomplish your goals to win a championship. So, especially in the East, you know.
No, I know. The East used to be the East was crazy. It's still.
Yeah. Well, I was going to say, it felt like sort of watching it, and then, you know, I was pretty young when it was happening, but, you know, watching it, sort of having that feeling, and then, like, thinking back to everything, it felt like. It was like, obviously there was Michael Jordan, but then it was like the New York Knicks. Like it was this like,
because it was
dual superstar, but you don't often get that. Like often you'll get, you know, even like when they played the Jazz or something, it was like, yeah, you have like, you know, the players on the Jazz, but you had like the two biggest superstars in basketball in the New York Knicks and Jordan.
No, that's true. That's like, so what was it like going through that?
Man, it was hell. you know, because we knew that they was, you know, the team that we had to get through. And, you know, and dealing with Michael, you know, was difficult
in itself. Big problem.
Add Scottie Pippen to the mix made it that even tough. Because I think, you know, you knew what Mike was going to give you, but Scottie was the X factor on that team. And, mm-hmm. you know, Mike talked about it. You know, obviously he needed Scotty to accomplish what he accomplished with those teams. And, you know, we knew that Scotty was the X factor because you try your best to get, you know, to get to Mike, but you're not getting to Mike. You know what I mean?
Right, yeah. He's
mentally stronger. So you had to, like, attack all the pieces around him. And hopefully that, you know, you can get to them and knock them off their game. But he wouldn't let them quit. You know, to his credit, he wouldn't let that team quit. Mm. And we thought we had him on the ropes, and he just seemed to rise to the occasion.
I remember.
You wish Scotty would have had that back problem in your series.
I know. So what you're saying is.
Exactly.
I mean, so, and this is, again, I'm a Knicks fan. This isn't a dig. What was it like playing for the Knicks when they were good? Like, when they were, like, the talk of the town. They were New York City, like, the best sports thing that was happening. That had to have been, like, crazy.
You're right. Insane. You're right. It was
crazy. He's like, yeah, you're right. Yeah, it was crazy.
Yeah. The city was just, man. The city was just electric during those times, you know. With us doing well and the Rangers doing well during those times, it was just crazy. I can remember times where I used to try to go shopping in New York City, and walking down the street, I had to duck into stores, and they literally had to bring the police to, like, so I could get in my car. It was that crazy during those times. And, you know, I wouldn't trade it for the world. You know, it was the best of times. The Garden was just off the hook.
Every single night.
You know what I mean? That we stepped, no matter who was playing, sold out every single night. You know, it was just fun times to be a New York Knicks, as well as the Rangers was doing very well themselves.
Yeah. Yeah, it'd be so dope. I've only been to the Garden a few times, and it's been recently. I think it sold out even when we were.
Yeah, no, I know.
Even in the recent
yeah,
times.
Yeah.
Who was your favorite celebrity that used to come to the games? Like, was there like some? I mean, obviously you have your, like, famous Knicks fans, but was there, like, some famous celebrities that were always there that just cracked you up or that you liked?
Well, Spike was my guy. You know what I mean? Spike was the number one. You know what I mean? He bleed, you know, blue and orange all day long. He was the number one. Man, there were so many celebrities used to come to the game. I can't remember.
I know. It's like probably everybody.
Yeah, everybody. You know.
Yeah.
I mean, it was fun just, you know, to see all these guys on Celebrity Row come out.
Yeah.
You know, as supporters night in and night out.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when we used to go to L.A. and play in Los Angeles,
mm-hmm.
All these New Yorkers that was L.A. fans, they come out with their Knicks jersey on when Knicks get to the town.
Yeah, exactly.
So they always true New York Knicks fans, even though they live in L.A. and work in L.A. and celebrities in L.A., but when we come to town, the true New Yorkers come out in.
Always. That's dope. That's dope. All right. So as it goes with the dunk, what was, like, the holy shit moment? Like, the moment where you were like, I just did that. Or the moment where you were like, dang, this is a big deal. Like, what was that holy shit moment?
Probably when I came down and hit the floor and started running back up the court. That was the moment, you know. But I was running back up to get back on defense. Then when my teammates came and started giving me high fives, that's when
pushing you back down to the floor. Yeah, they were going hard on you.
Exactly. And then the fans were just going bonkers. They were just off the chain once that play happened. And so I knew it was a very special play, but I didn't know how special it was until I came back and started working for the Knicks. And I can honestly say somebody asked me about that play every single day since 2004.
I'm like, dang. So we're just like we're two of them.
It is so good.
It's hard
though.
Not to ask about it.
Like, it's so good, especially for, like, you know, a smaller guy to just get up over everyone, like, with your offhand and just, like, against.
You dunk with your left a lot, though.
Against Jordan.
I was doing some research.
Yeah,
you dunk with your left a lot.
Yeah, off of two. I jump better going that way than one for whatever reason. You know what I mean? It's probably because I got one leg longer than the other.
Always
some
messed up.
I feel more comfortable going that way. So, yeah. But you guys know, both of you guys know, when you were in the moment, you're really not thinking about it. And, you know, yeah. you knew that you did something special, but you're really not thinking about it. So you're just kind of focusing on the task at hand. Mm-hmm. Probably later on down the road that, okay, you look back and say, oh, wow, that was a special play.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh, it was so
well,
good.
Speaking of special plays, we do have two games that we like to play on the show. Mm-hmm. And the first one is called Just Give Me a Reason. So we're going to show you some gifts. Okay. And then you have to tell us what was happening. So this is our little intro. Just give me a reason, just a little bit some more. Just a second, we're not broken, just okay. Oh. So you got to tell us. What was happening?
That's, I'm not going to say the word, but that's, you know, get off me.
Yeah. Yeah, I feel you.
No, that, just a little headbutt.
Did anything happen before this? Like before this play?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He was hitting me. He was hitting me with bows.
I mean, it's Reggie Miller.
Yeah, I was telling the referees he's hitting me with bows, and they just telling me to shut up. Then Right before that, he hit me with another ball, and I ran down, got the ball, and I think I scored 2 points. Then I was just like irate at that moment. Because Patrick asked me to play before. He said, are you cool? I said, yeah, because I didn't want him to grab me.
Yeah. You knew he was going to pull you back.
I'm fine.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
I'm fine.
But, you know, during those times back then, you know, players had to earn their respect in the league, not so much like it is now, where the respect is given to you as soon as you come in the league. But back then, you know, you're playing against grown men instead of young, you know, teenagers now.
Mm-hmm.
And so back then, you had to earn your respect. And to like Reggie had to earn his respect when he first came in the league. And he probably was getting the same treatment that he was trying to give me.
Yeah, but once he learned it from somewhere.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Once I did it here, but, you know, Reggie backed off and I didn't have no more problems out of Reggie for the rest of my career.
Yeah, that's a good way. Yeah, it's a good method.
Yeah,
that's true.
I'm cool with you, John. I'm cool with you now.
Exactly.
All right, so.
You know, we just like going into the parks. If nobody know who you are, you have to earn your respect.
Yeah,
you have to earn your respect.
Okay, so I kind of know what's happening here, but, you know.
Oh, yeah, that's after we won game 6.
Mm-hmm.
I went down there again, and them fans were looking at Spike like, we can't wait to get to you. I remember Spike in the locker room, and back in the back as we was pulling off in the bus, and he looked so lonely. He's all by himself, and and they was telling me, okay, you got to leave. He's like, I'm not getting out of here until y'all give me an escort.
That's true, because you were in Indiana, right?
Yeah,
we was in Indiana.
Yeah, no, that's...
So, you know, he was draped in Knicks.
Yeah, he's like, leave here by myself.
Draped in the Knicks. dangerous. So this next one, you know, I'm assuming not your finest, but
I like it. I'm here for that.
We appreciate this.
I'm here.
You know
for
what that was?
Sometimes
that
me too.
Me, that was me ticked off. We just lost game number 5. Yeah, game number 5 in Miami. So we were still up 3-2. We just lost coming off the court. And some fans said something to me, and the whole arena was yelling. You know, they said something to me. I am not going to say what it was. And that's what gave me, like, I just flipped them off as I was walking to the bench, right? And as soon as I sat down, and that's when the fight broke out. And when PJ Brown flipped Charlie Ward. And I didn't even think at the time. I just saw Charlie's feet go up in the air, and I just took off and, you know, went over there. And you know, Patrick, you know, that's bad memories.
So was it
suspended for that game?
Was it this fan?
Yeah, there she go.
Yeah, exactly. Karen.
He liked it too.
Yeah.
She was like, I approve of that.
We'll see what happened there.
Yeah.
You know she's gonna talk to me.
Exactly.
Hey, Sue, Megan.
Yeah.
I felt so bad after that because I was me and Herb was sitting at a diner. You know, when we got back to town, we got this little diner where I live at, and we used to go in for breakfast before we go to practice. And this fan came up to me. He said, "Will you sign this autograph?" And when I saw it in print, I like, oh. I felt bad. I went ahead and signed it for him, but I felt bad.
Yeah.
That's funny, though.
That's funny.
Good one.
All right. So next, we've got rapid fire.
Yeah.
They're not tricky. I promise.
Okay.
Okay. You ready?
Yep.
Okay. Okay. John Starks, rapid fire. Here we go. Which was more difficult, guarding Michael Jordan or packing groceries for a bunch of Karens?
Guarding Michael Jordan.
Okay, okay. Who is the best Knick ever?
Patrick Ewing.
Good answer. Who's your favorite teammate of all time?
I can't give you just one teammate. All of them.
Okay.
I'd say all of them.
Which dunk was more important to your career? The one on Michael Jordan, the dunk, or the one you attempted on Patrick Ewing that got you hurt?
The one on Patrick Ewing.
Ah. So for those that don't know, you could tell the story. It's a great story.
Yeah, it was the last day of training camp, and I wasn't sure if I was going to make the team or not, so I wanted to impress the coaches. So I tried to go up and dunk on Patrick Ewing and forgot he was 7 foot that could jump. And he caught my dunk. I came down, twisted my knee, and I thought I had tore it up. He felt bad about it, but it was kind of like a blessing in disguise because it put me on the IR.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't know at the time when you go on IR that they couldn't cut you. So he gave me a chance to stick around. So it was
crazy. Sometimes it's all it takes. Okay. So which Knick play is the best ever? Is it LJ's 4-point play? Or is it your dunk?
My dunk.
Your dunk?
You think I'm going to give LJ that?
No way. I heard you guys like to get into it.
No way. My dunk. I hope you're listening to LJ.
That's funny. All right. What's the better Knick story? Is it Willis Reed in the playoff or the finals? Or is it Linsanity?
Oh, Willis Reed.
Willis Reed. I know. Every time you win a championship, it's like
they
won it. Him coming out and knocking down those two buckets, and they just kind of like lit the fire underneath them. And then Clyde went off that game. Went off.
Yeah, and that's the ring. Definitely. That's the one we have.
That's the one.
Okay, so when you're introduced by the Knicks, you know, at guard, it says you're 6'5".
Well, you already know I'm not 6'5".
We're just checking. All right.
That makes your dunk more impressive.
Exactly. I know. You should have told him immediately, make me 6'2". All right. What's your favorite cigar? I heard you're into cigars.
Yeah. John Starks Legend number 3.
Okay. What's your favorite golf course? Because I heard you like to smoke the cigar on the golf course.
Man. There's so many of them, but the best one I ever played, I think, for me, was Augusta.
Okay. That's got to be
like
a legit
choice. Walking on hollow ground there.
Yeah. Okay. So you played for the Bulls in 2000. Was that weird?
What? Yes, it was weird.
Okay.
I didn't know that until we were doing our research. I was like, what?
Yeah, I didn't know it either.
Yeah, it was for one week. 1 week, and I got kicked out of there.
Yeah,
you were like, right out the middle finger.
Didn't smell right. Okay, speaking of the Bulls, if Jordan and the 98 Bulls had stayed together for the 1999 season, would they have beaten the San Antonio Spurs that year? And that's the team, for everyone who doesn't know, that won in 1999.
Yeah. That's a good question, because Tim Duncan, I think it was his second year there.
Mm-hmm.
And he was beasting at that time. I don't know. That's a toss-up for me.
That's a toss-up?
San Antonio had a good team that year, obviously. And but, you know, Chicago still had Michael.
And then there was Michael.
Always Michael. When you give him a challenge, he seems to rise to the occasion. So,
yeah,
I'll probably have to go with Chicago anyway. So, keep it in the East.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. This is it. A yes or no question. You can only say yes or no. Did you dunk on Jordan?
Yes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. You're just. My Twitter comments were insane that day. Okay.
Yeah, you got into some stats.
Which coach
jump,
was...
He did jump to try to block it, right?
Yeah. I know. And then he made a business decision. He still dumped on him.
He got some of that.
He dumped all over him.
Okay, which coach was your favorite? Like, which coach did you like the best? Pat Riley, Don Nelson, or Jeff Van Gundy?
Pat Riley.
Pat Riley? Okay. So, just real quick, how many coaches have the Knicks had?
Ooh, that's a good question.
Too many to answer?
Yeah, I can't answer that.
Okay, two every year. All right, let's go with some New York City questions. What's your favorite New York City restaurant?
Virgil's.
Okay. What's the best slice of pizza?
Oh, man. Skip that one.
Okay, that I'm like that so one's you can do like all of them.
You got so many great.
Yeah, I'm like even when it's like a dollar a slice, I'm like I'll take it.
Yeah,
okay.
Exactly.
What's your favorite Broadway show?
I'm not a Broadway guy. Okay.
What about a concert? Have you seen any concerts?
I have seen concerts. Jay-Z put on a show at the Garden. Yeah.
I would pay. I mean, you do pay. But okay. Speaking of Jay-Z, what's your favorite New York City rapper?
Probably him and Biggie.
Okay. See, I knew I was gonna like you. Okay. So, what was your go-to pregame music?
Oh man, I'm old school. I got to go through some Funkadelics.
Oh.
George Clinton.
Yeah. No, I know.
Yeah.
Okay. Why do you wear number 3?
You know, people ask me that all the time. It was just handed to me.
That's a great answer. Sometimes it's just that simple.
I know, right? And they just hand it to me.
Okay, so do you think you were an overachiever or do you think you were underappreciated?
I think I was a overachiever.
Okay.
Yeah, I do. You know what I mean? Because, I was undersized for that position at the time. So I had to work extremely hard in order to compete. So I overachieved.
Okay, so who in the NBA now reminds you of yourself?
Westbrook.
Oh, just goes 100.
Yeah, just the mentality.
Doesn't give a, that's true. Mentality. We'll get up in anyone's face. I see it.
Yeah.
I see it.
He don't cheat the fans. That's what I love about him.
Yeah, that's true. Okay, 3-pointers or the mid-range?
3-pointers for sure.
Okay. Not analytics. That's just like you actually like it.
That's the knockout punch.
Okay.
3-pointers is just like, man, it just takes something out of a team when you knock those down. Yeah.
All right. What was your biggest adjustment when you got to New York City?
Ooh, the city. The city at that time, oh, man. It was grimy.
It was.
Times Square, oh.
Yeah, man. It was grimy. You're right. What year did you get there?
I got there in 1990.
Okay. Yeah, it's like pre Giuliani. All the crime was crazy. No, you're right. It was grimy. So just like everything was adjusted.
Yeah.
But it's beautiful now.
It is.
Yeah.
Okay. How many wins will the Knicks have in their next full season?
I'm shooting for 50.
50?
Yeah.
All right. Heard it here first. I would love to see that.
That would be amazing.
Okay. Who wins a fight? Prime Oakley or Prime Mason?
Oh, what you talking about? Them two heads up? Man, they probably be still fighting to this day.
Yeah. No winners. It's just going
no
for days.
Winners. No winners.
Okay.
Yeah,
I actually believe
that. That's true. Yeah. They might kill each other.
Okay. We can't see you, so we're going to have to change this up. All right.
Okay.
Don't say anything. If Biggie's I've Got a Story to Tell is about Anthony Mason.
No.
Oh. Okay.
The world wants to know.
I like how you did. Simultaneously.
There was a fan question, though, that we probably should get into really fast. What was the locker room like after Biggie dropped that song?
Be honest with you. Never entered the locker room. Nobody ever talked about it. Yeah.
Okay. Cool. I'm actually not that surprised. Sometimes stuff just like doesn't.
It's just like whatever.
Exactly.
Okay. This is a game we play. We're going to change it up for you. It's start, bench, or cut. Okay. Larry Johnson.
Bench.
Allen Houston. He said bench.
Bench Larry. Bench him.
Bench Larry. All right. Allen Houston and Doc Rivers.
Oh, start. Bench. LJ. Bench him.
He's out. He's just out. I'm going to bench and cut him. I'm going to start the other two.
You know I got number love for LJ. So.
Oh, that's funny. Did you play with him?
Yeah, I played with LJ.
Okay. How many years?
That actually was when him and Allen came, that actually was our best all-around team, I thought.
That's true.
Just from an offensive team.
So, like, something that people, I feel like, don't know about you. Okay, so they might know that you got Sixth Man of the Year in 97. But I feel like what's fascinating about it is that you went from, like, a starter on a team in the finals, and then you took the role of coming off the bench and, like, excelled in that and got Sixth Man of the Year. Because I know that was probably when Allen got there and whatnot.
Yeah, exactly.
So I just have a ton of respect for that. And in your honor, I'm just going to give you a little P-Funk. No, we thank you so much for coming on. Technical difficulties was worth the wait. We appreciate it.
This is cool. I appreciate you guys and all the success to both of you.
Same. And from one Nick fan, I was 13 years old on this day. Thank you for the dunk and many other memories.
All right, thank you.
Thank you for the memories. Right, take care, John.
You guys. All right, Sue, Megan, you guys, take care.
See you later.
All right.
Fuck it all. Last it all.
I'm so excited for Mimi Week.
I know. That was awesome. I really wish you'd have seen him. That was a bummer. And I know the volume wasn't great, but guys, we just got to interview John Starks.
I know, she was dope.
And it was epic.
We gotta, like,
I feel like I could have asked him
go have
so
a drink
many more
with him
questions. He does so much cool shit with his foundation, John Starks Foundation.
Check it out.
He's like a cigar guy.
Cigar guy. There cigar aficionado.
All right, guys. I mean, we've been so excited for Memes of the Week. I can't even. I'm so excited.
Guys.
So I'm going to turn this down. There's no volume, so that won't be a problem. And here we are, guys. Memes of the Week.
Memes
are you ready?
Memes of the week.
All right, I got to get there. Okay.
We'll find it.
I'm going to do it manually because I think it's just better.
Okay.
Boom, we're here.
Okay.
And let us begin. Meme number one.
Obviously. Yeah,
so clearly we're doing a Michael Jordan themed memes of the week.
We had to wrap up.
I'm keeping the music on.
The Last Dance.
It's amazing how quiet it is when there's no music.
He knew.
Okay. Next meme of the week.
I mean, just saying.
MJ, I mean, he was impressed.
Why wouldn't you be?
I know. I totally agree.
11-year-old?
Rocking some J's?
We had 11s?
We should have asked John where his favorite Jordans are. That was another fan question we didn't get to.
Yeah. What? Why did you eat that pizza, though?
By himself.
That's so crazy.
At 2 in the morning.
30 in the morning, you ate a full pizza.
Is Utah known for their pizza?
That, like, came with red flags. No, they're not known for their pizza.
I don't even know what food they're known for. Not well, pizza. Apparently this one made Jordan laugh. Let's see what it is. Oh! He would laugh at that. He's probably like, man, you think I'm number 3 on this list? I don't know, though. I feel like we're pretty high, and I know the wood memes are high because I see them everywhere.
I mean, in terms of what I'm seeing and what I'm hearing, you know, out on these streets, this is really the list.
All right, so this one has volume. If you cannot hear the volume, tell us immediately.
Yeah.
Yeah.
no sound.
No sounds?
Okay, hold on.
No volume? Okay. So we had a feeling since the last one didn't work. How do I get it up? All right. I gotta figure that out.
We don't know.
It's so weird. Did the Go New York song work?
We don't know.
I let it go, girlfriend.
Don't worry.
Okay. It's gonna be better this way because it's gonna be louder.
We're up.
Okay. I gotta find it. Okay, guys. Now the volume's on.
Wait, oh no, there's no volume.
It's okay. I have backups.
Oh my God, I was like,
there's always backups. I can't find it.
It's because it's connected right to that.
That's why. Oh, it should. Is this on? Yeah, we're good. Okay. Here we go. It's gonna stream, so just listen up.
Shocking. What is that? Is there a rocking spider back there?
We're in the well.
Comfortable. I'm in my car.
You guys, I farted last
week. Who knew? Who knew Jordan 6 hours before tip-off was jamming to a touch more?
He was having a blast. That's what he was doing.
And there it is, guys. We were very excited. That was a lot of legwork by the people that help us with the show and us as well. No, you did. You played your part for real. So it was
really bad.
It was a lot of fun to do that. We were very excited about those memes.
We loved it. We loved it.
We did love it.
It was fun. Thanks for entertaining us. Yes, we hyped up our own memes. Someone said that earlier.
I know. I saw it. I was like,
don't think I didn't catch that shade.
I caught it. It's funny. Like, wait a minute. They hyped up their own memes?
That's kind of funny.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, obviously.
You know how hard it is to get something in that iPad?
Yeah.
I don't either. I didn't do it. But I had to put faces on things.
It's very hard is what it is.
I know. That's what it is. So yeah, guys, sorry for the technical difficulties.
Yeah, it's okay.
And hopefully we made it work. It was a fun week. Go New York. Go New York, go.
And yeah, now, playlist is up. And the whole thing will be on YouTube. On our YouTube channel.
Time.
And what else? What do we got coming up this week?
This week?
We don't quite know. But as always, send me information about New York.
You actually did really well.
Did I do pretty good?
Yeah, nobody knows the answers to those questions. That's why it was kind of funny to like see what your guesses were. You know what I mean?
I did all right. I actually did a lot better than I thought that I was going to do.
I think you thought I was going to give you like ones you should, like everyone should know. You know what I mean? So there was like more pressure. These ones, nobody knows.
Who knows that
the ice cream cone was invented? Although someone was like, it was invented in St. Louis. All right, thank you guys for joining us and staying with us during the technical difficulties. Now it's time.
B-I-G.
You know we had to do it.
Give it up for y'all.
For a remix.
Wow. Remix! I used to read word up magazine. On my wall. Every Saturday, rap attack, Mr. Magic, Molly Moore. I let my tape rock till my tape pop. Smoke the weed and bamboo, sipping on pop and stop. Way back when I had the red and black lumberjack with the hat to match. Remember rapping through the hard, the hard. You never thought that hip hop would take it this far. Now I'm in the limelight cause I rhyme tight. Time to get paid, blow up like the world trade. Blow up, the opposite of a winner when I used to eat sardines for dinner. And if you don't know, now you know.
This one?
It's on to you.
Next time.
See you next.